Welcome to today's Grow It Green. I'm joined by Margaret Hagen from the UNH Cooperative Extension. And Margaret, we're going to be talking about an insect that's been in the news lately. We've been thinking it might be coming, and indeed it's here.
It is here, and that's emerald ash borer, unfortunately.
And why is this such a big concern, first off?
In New Hampshire, it's a big concern because we have about 6% of our forest is ash, and so that equals about 750 million trees. And in our neighborhoods along our city streets, we probably have another 25 million trees. It's a very popular landscape tree. It's also a concern because it comes into the state on firewood, and it can be transported around on nursery stock and sometimes on boards. So there is a quarantine in effect for moving wood around and bringing things into the state, and it just makes it difficult for industry as well as homeowners who might find it in their yard.
And it might be kind of difficult for those homeowners to spot it. Here, I've got a little picture here. Why don't you tell us what we're looking at? You can see the penny there.
Right, you've got the penny, which puts this little exit hole for the adult beetle in perspective. They're D-shaped holes and they're quite small. And the adult beetles will emerge anytime between the end of May on in, and you'll find flying adults all the way up until October 1st. And they're a really bright, shiny green beetle, about the size of the head of a nickel. And what the larval stage or the caterpillar stage does, or the larval stage does is it bores underneath the bark and makes these galleries, and that's what actually kills the tree over time.
And what does it look like in terms of a tree that's dying?
A tree that's in bad shape after it's been infested, and trees die in 3 to 4 years usually, the top will be almost totally died out, and you'll find a lot of brushy shooting down near the base of the trunk of the tree. And it really is pretty quick, 3 to 4 years. And one of the things that New Hampshire has been doing actually for the last three or four years is they have about 350 of these purple prism traps out, and the traps help to attract the beetles so that we can keep an eye on where they might be coming into a new location.
And I gather these beetles are rather tough to eradicate, right? You can't spray or anything.
Unfortunately, it started in the upper Midwest in Michigan, and they lost tens of millions of trees that had to be cut down and destroyed because it's very expensive to treat.
So if you think you might have spotted something like this, is there anything to do?
Yeah, you can take some pictures, and then you can go to nhbugs.org. You can upload those pictures and fill out a form, and someone will get back in touch with you.
And also be careful where you get that firewood from.
Right, and you might want to think twice about putting in a new ash tree this year.
All right. Well, thanks very much. Some good advice. As always, if you have any questions, you can get in touch with the Cooperative Extension. That's it for today's Grow It Green. Back to you in the studio.